Back to my channel, Mr. Brown 57. So today I'm just going to share with you what I've done to my Lotrax pre-runner. All right, here we go. So it's my Lotrax pre-runner 4x4, and inside of it I have a Hobby Wing, I think 1080 brushes, ESC, and also I have a, you can see right there, get that in there, got a V-Line 380 brushes motor, and you can see the Hobby Wing ESC down off in there a little bit. The wheels and tires, I got them off of Amazon. I think it's like $20. They're normally for like a 110 scale RC car, perfect size. And as you can see here, I made a custom front bumper. So let's step back from it. So I made a custom front bumper for it. Because I'm going to eventually not turn it into a full rock crawler, but I'm gonna turn it into a crawler, but it won't be a full lock. I bought a rear spool. I bought a spool for the rear, because I don't do any bashing, jumping, and all that carry on. But if you can see right down in here, we can get the light over here. Yeah, you can see right down in there. So what I done was I have an axle SCX10 first edition, and so what I done was let me slap this body off for you right quick here. So you can see, in order to get this 380 to fit, I had to do just a little grinding on this little plastic chassis. But if you can see, that's the Hobby Wing ESC. Very smooth ESC, very, very smooth. And so in order to get the front shocks to expand, I had some plastic holes, and I just cut a little piece and made little sleeves for that. And then right here, you can see in the bumper, what I done was I drilled a couple of self-tapping screws in there. But I can still have access to the front dip if I need to. Yeah, I can get to those two screws. And I can also get in to those two screws and those two screws. And I think it looks pretty cool. It's pretty strutty. So I can hold it like that. So what I had to do the first time was I had to glue it so it'll stay together, and once I glued it, I went ahead and shot a screw here, screw there, and then I shot two screws down here, two screws down there, and these are what I call the little rock slider that comes with the axle SCS10, the first gen. And what I done was I just cut one and cut the other one. I mean, it's plastic, I don't use them anyway, so that's how I ended up getting this modification done. So you guys tell me what you think. I think it's pretty cool. I think it's pretty cool. I like tinkering, you know. And I don't think it's a knock against putting a nice little front bumper on there. Then once you put the body back on there, it's just looking nice and sweet. Get that whole line up there. Yeah, I think it looks pretty cool. But I think I'm going to take the heat gun, and I'm going to kind of like put a little bend to it, kind of like bend it up. I mean, it looks straight. I don't know, maybe just my eyes. But other than that, I think it looks pretty slick. I didn't want to put all the decals on it and all that. That's just my taste for it. But anyway, so these were the shocks that I was going to put on there. I got these... I think they're called Harvey Park or something like that. So I got these shocks off Amazon. Three of them was good. The fourth one didn't have a rubber seal in the screw down cap. We're missing a rubber seal. So I got to send these back. And so I got some new ones coming in. So you guys tell me what you think. I think she looks pretty sick. Yeah. I think she just looks pretty sick. Nice stance and having this front bumper. And then we get to crawling, you know. I think it looks pretty sick. All right, peace out. If you like, comment, and maybe you want to subscribe, subscribe. I work so much, you know, working a regular job, working for myself. So, plus I'm not good at editing videos, you know, making them all fancy. Would mean you're just going to get straight, rugged, raw video. That's just me. Okay. Love everybody. Peace out. Bye.